Tell us about yourself po muna, sir.
Well, I'm a prosecutor with the Caloocan City Prosecutor's Office. But even before that, I've been a supporter of the president. No, what more important is that my support of what he represents, which is change, progress, a focus on people program, people-oriented programs, yung may puso talaga sa, yung pinakawala sa atin. Actually, ano doon, natamaan ako doon sa tapang at malasakit because that really embodies yung strongest character ni President. Matapang, he really means courage pala. And malasakit because, you know, at a certain age, dapat nagpapahinga na siya. He has been a successful mayor. He has nothing more to prove. But for the nation, he sacrificed his comfort for all the rest of us. To be honest, itong tapang at malasakit, it's something that people have to take heart because we are building a country again. Ang importante talaga yung identification natin sa movement. The movement is bigger than the personality. But I'm very, yes, very glad na may face na yung ating movement, which is the mayor of Davao City. The call is for everybody. Wala tayong sinabi. This is not a PDP laban movement. Hindi political party. It's everybody. We are building a big tent. You can all go inside that big tent for one particular purpose, which is to build this country. Ang aking main contribution dito is to do my job as asked by our good president, which is to help clean up crime and criminality. So, doon tayo. Yes, tapang natin dito is ganito. Hindi madali ang magiging next 6 years. Maraming basura tayong kailangang linisin. Maraming masasaktan dahil magbabago ang sistema. Maraming tatamaan kasi yung mga racket, pinagkapirahan, lahat ng mga kanilang pinakinabangan, mawawala. Change kasi is always painful. Nobody said it was easy. There's always a price for change. Tolerate the continuation of jeepneys na inefficient compared to mass transportation. Yung ordinaryong empleyado ang makikinabang na mas mabilis yung commerce, mas mabilis pumasok sa trabaho, mas marami tayong magagawa sa araw. That's an improvement. Pollution. Diba? That's an improvement. Yung current vehicles natin, which is matanda na, ang maintenance cost yan mataas din on the long run. Whereas yung mga bagong jeep are newer, mas lower ang maintenance, clean burning, and it has more passengers na kayang i-accommodate.
Yes.
So, may ano yan, meron namang offsetting. Hindi naman kaagad din yan. And I'm sure kung mahirapan yung ating mga drivers to acquire it in the beginning, i-adjust na lang siguro yung subsidy ng government para mas maging madali mag-acquire para sa mga drivers. So it's a question of money, not really a question of displacement employment.
Yes. Yes. That's good, sir. So please, mga ka-DDS, malinaw po yun na talagang once po we're being productive and modernized, we can also gain employment with that. Kasi syempre, we need technicians, di ba po, sir? And we need drivers as well.
We need to adjust our entire... We have to upgrade to the latest, hindi naman latest, more on environment-friendly technology.
Oh, federalism, sir. What's your stand on it?
Yes, it should be pursued. It should be pursued because, ano na kung bahay pa natin, you know, all this, parang puro tayo band-aid Puro palit-pintura, ganun. We have to admit, bulok na yung bahay. We have to change either... We have to rebuild talaga because hindi na sustainable yung system natin. It may have worked before nung mababa ang population natin, but as technology and history has moved on, we should also be realistic na we need a new system. So I'm very supportive of federalism. We have to make local governments more accountable. We have to make local governments more functional. Huwag kayo umasa lahat sa Imperial Manila. Pangit kasi yung Manila-centric governance, iasa natin sa president lahat. Let's start holding the LGUs. Give LGUs more power.
Yes.
Yung lang na gusto ko sa federalism actually is that pag kumita yung lugar mo, like Davao, you know, you get to keep more money instead of sending it to the national government.
Exactly, sir.
Kasi federalized ka na So, you have to generate your own funds and you get to determine anong kailangan mo. Kung hindi ka asa kung sinong nasa Maynila, kung anong ibibigay sa'yo parang limos. Di ba? Kasi ang problema kasi kung Manila-centric lahat, eh kayo nagtatakbuhan yung tao dito sa Maynila kasi andito yung pera eh. Whereas kung yung pera is nag-i-stay kung sino saan kumikita, of course, meron yung mga lugar talaga, hindi ka nat-generate as much money. Yun ang kailangan ng tulong.
Yes, no, exactly, sir.
Hindi naman sila pababayaan. Pero yung mga self-sustaining na at magaganda yung government governance nila, let them develop as a alternative center of development. Yun ang sa akin. For now kasi, more people have to speak up kung gusto nila ng RevGov, for RevGov to be, to move, no? Meron kasi provision sa 1986 Constitution na there's a certain mass of numbers that can dissolve the entire government, which is yung percentage per district, and then you have a total number ng ganon. Once we acquire that by proper petition, lahat tayo, wag, kasi I don't want to think of violence kasi. Na mag-revgov tayo because it will hurt people, no?
Yes, opo.
It will create instability sa atin is there's a peaceful revolution mechanism, which is yung constituent assembly natin, and then let's just tear everything down based on that mandate. Yun ang iniisip. There's a mechanism to dissolve the government by people's initiative, which is not violent, which is not unstable. It does not hurt anybody. It's perfectly legal and acceptable. Wala namang OFW na gusto umalis sa country if they had a choice. Eh. Maraming OFWs na pressure sa family, poverty, meron silang kanya-kanyang tragic story. And we have to acknowledge na people go abroad for different reasons. But yung ina-address natin siguro ito yung mga OFWs na umalis to sacrifice because they had no choice. For you, we have a president that thinks about you as an OFW.
Yes.
Hindi man namin maalis yung reasons ninyo for leaving. What we can do is extend you with the little comforts that we can. First of all, yung sa customs, you can send balikbayan boxes.
Yes, tax, sir. Totoo po yan.
Diba? That's good news for you.
Yes,
ang balikbayan box naman, hindi man kayong kumikita dyan eh. It's a piece of yourself that you're sending to people you love. Tanimbala, the uncertainty of leaving your country without being harassed or kinikikilang. Ang pinakamalaking bagay sa akin siguro is that example is being made by the president himself. Yung work ethic niya pa lang, alam naman natin ang difference ng work style ng bawat president. Pero yung contrast between the last administration and the president's active schedule is very, very, very glaring eh. Ano excuse namin sa government not to follow that? A 72-year-old guy can be such active. He can do that. Ano excuse namin not to follow?
Yes.
As an example, lahat tayo, yun pa lang eh. Being a model of work ethic, malaking bagay na yun eh. There's no more excuse for us to say na wala akong magawa. The guy is fighting, this old guy is fighting for us. How can we not follow? People are asked to serve. Fewer people are asked to serve as president pa. And this is the only guy who appreciated the burden of being a president. For me, ha, this is the president who would not want to be president. But he agreed because sa tingin niya, He can give something to the people. Dumami trabaho namin.
Oh. Bakit po?
Which is actually a good thing, no? Yung mga dating hindi napapansin for one reason or another is napapansin na ngayon. Minsan kasi iniisip mo everybody's trying to make it appear everything is okay, you know. You want peace of mind na. Pero alam naman natin sa totoo lang, hindi ganun kalinis or hindi ganun ka peaceful sa lugar mo. As a Filipino, tinuturuan niya tayong tumayo sa sariling paa eh.
Yes.
Yung tulong, pero may kapalit. Sakit naman 'yon. Parang ginagawa tayong gago. We need better training actually. The type of governance that we used to before is no longer working. Current world natin ngayon, we move so fast. You need fast decision making. You have expert. You need expert decision making. And for that reason, maybe the private sector, which is more faster ang movement, government money has to be spent for services. Because if you have an efficient government that is running well, the economic activity will reward you eh. Mas maraming magkakatrabaho, mas maraming taxes to be collected, ganun. So para sa akin, kung andyan yung pera, igasto sa kailangan. Sa pension, sa SSS, yung ayaw nila ibigay yung increase kasi bababa daw yung fund. Kailan mo ibibigayan pagpatay na yung matanda? Trillanes is just one person. No? Out there are so many Duterte supporters that can talk to people, to foreigners that they know, and correct the any misimpression made by Senator Trillanes. OFW, you have to be active also in talking to the foreigners, telling what this guy is saying is wrong. Diba? Sabihin mo sa kanya, eh no, hindi totoo yan. Ang alam ko, this is what is really happening. Do not believe media. Ganun. Because they're hearing it from you. Nakilala nila. So, ginagamit mo yung sarili mong credibility sa foreigner. Well, nagtitiis na tayo for the past years on atrocious conditions. Eh. We've been paying taxes without getting our money's worth. We've been electing bad people to public office. And this cannot be fixed in one lifetime or in 1 year.
It
has to start somewhere. Oo. So ang pinakaano ko dun talaga is, ang sacrifice natin is talaga is, marami tayong masakit na maririnig, maraming babato sa atin. Let's learn to ignore kung anong issue papatulan natin. Kung intriga lang naman, bakit pa natin papansinin, di ba? Waste of time. And we will just be arguing with a pointless issue. Piliin natin yung issues na papatulan. And the issue should be based on truth. Well, ako as a public official, ang gusto ko naman talaga due process. Mm. So if there's evidence, huliin nyo. You have to learn not to be afraid of the syndicates. Huwag kayong magpapatahimik sa mga kapitbahay at kabarangay ninyo na nasa illegal na gawain. President has made a decision. Whether we approve or not, let's just tingnan muna natin kung to give the president's decision time to have an effect. Kung maganda naging decision niya, support it. Philippines is an archipelago. Each island in that country is an entry point for drugs.
Yes.
More than ever, the president needs our prayer. He is overworking. For me, he's overworking. Yung araw niya, ako nahihilo. Ako, 8 hours a day, bagsak na ako. After 8 hours. The guy, mula pagising hanggang madaling araw, is working. So,
kaya nga po.
Ang sa akin is, the presidency is not a sprint. It's a marathon. Kasi you have to finish the 6 years. And I can understand why he's impatient. Ang sa akin lang is he should take care of himself talaga. You know, he loves this country and he wants to do what he can in the little time that he has. But sa akin lang naman kasi is we're willing to give him the extra time that he needs. Don't be so demanding of the president. He has a plan and he has a vision. He cannot attend to every problem that you have. Yung problema nyo, kung merong agency concerned, dumiretso na kayo doon. Asikasuhin naman kayo noon. At pag hindi kayo nasikaso, ireklamo nyo. Don't try to put every problem his way because he's thinking of bigger things. Yun lang yun. Be mature about how we run the government. Huwag tayo parang bata na pag hindi na pagbigyan, iiyak na.
I thank you po and I will let you be kasi I know you're very busy. Maraming salamat po sa oras po ninyo and hanggang sa muli po, Sir Darwin. Paalam!
Paalam.